Good morning. Happy New Year. Welcome to Community Builder, hosted by Habitat for Humanity. My name is Prasaadi. I am the Director of Development and Marketing at Habitat. Today, we are going to talk about ReStore, Women Build, and Birdhouse Challenge 2018. Today, I have here with me Joe Marmontello from ReStore and Penny Hummel, who is our Director of Family Services and our Volunteer Coordinator. Thank you for being here. Let's start talking about ReStore. So Joe, tell me about ReStore. What is ReStore, where it is, and some information about how people can get involved or donate items.
Well, first of all, it's called the Habitat for Humanity of Berks County ReStore. We're located 5370 Allentown Pike, Temple, Pennsylvania, 19560. It's pretty much in the Walmart shopping center, located in the little strip mall down from there. We're one of the major income sources for the Habitat Building Program, and we sell gently used furniture, appliances, building supplies, and also some very unique items that you need to come out and see. They're priced at 50 to 70% off retail, and you can also see them on our Facebook page, which would be our Berks ReStore page. Also, we have a new thing we're trying out. You can also reserve, call us and reserve the item. We take credit cards over the phone. And it's really a must-see story. We can't really tell you what we have. We don't have the normal sofa or the normal screen door, but we have, I like to say, everything but the kitchen sink. Well, we have the kitchen sink. And we have the vanity to go with it, and we have all the supplies to go with it. And I think a lot of people just don't realize what kind of store that we have. So it's a really unique store.
I see. So we have these unique items at our ReStore. So do you want to tell our audience how we get these items? And if anyone's interested in maybe donating something to a ReStore, how would
we get everything is donated from us. We're very grateful for what we get. So a couple things you can call and donate to us. I just ask you to be patient, because sometimes we do get 30 to 40 calls a day, and we only have a few people doing them, one, two maybe. So we are within 2 weeks to 2.5 weeks for your pickup, depending on the area you live in. All you'd have to do is call 610-921-1315 extension 1 and talk to Colleen. And she will schedule you an appointment for us to pick it up, or you can drop it off. Usually Monday and Tuesday, since the store is closed, you can drop off from 9 to 1 in the, behind the store, and then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday from 9 to 4:35, and then Sunday from 1 to 4. Now what we try and do is we try and give all our customers a great experience on shopping and try and give them the best items that we can give them. So we are a little bit selective on what we take. If you have a sofa that is ripped or torn, we probably won't accept that. What we try and say, if you would go into a store like ours and you would buy what you're going to donate to us, then we would probably accept it. So by us being a little bit selective gives our customers a great choice of what we have. Plus, it also brings our program in more money.
Absolutely. And so from what I also understand is we are the only service in Berks County that does pickups. Donation pickups.
That's right.
And can you once again just specify for our audience when they can call and schedule a pickup?
You can call any Monday through Friday from 8 to 4. Like I said, 610-921-1315, extension 1. And either leave a message for Colleen or she will pick up, and she can schedule your donation. We try and get in 5 to 6 to 7 donations a day. What we would appreciate if you would get everything should be on the first floor or in the garage or in the driveway. What that allows us to do is it allows us to do more stops each day. So, and also for the safety of our driver and helper, also for the safety of the item you're donating, and also the safety of your house. We're not professional movers. So bringing the sofa down the steps, if it's not safe and we don't want to ruin your railing or your wall or anything like that. So we ask you to have it on the first floor, which allows all them things for us to do get more stops in that day.
That's great.
That's what we would ask.
Thank you, Joe.
You're welcome.
So I'm going to turn over to Penny now. She's our Director of Family Services and Volunteer Coordinator. She is going to talk a little bit about our volunteer needs at Habitat as well as Women Build 2018.
Thanks, Prasaadi. We run by volunteer labor. We do have some paid staff, but a lot of what we do happens because of the volunteers who help us do it. At the ReStore, we are always in need of volunteers. We can have people working as sales associates, helping the customers find what they need and that sort of thing. We could use greeters, saying hello to people as they walk in the door. There's also opportunities for cleaning, stocking shelves, straightening up shelves, as well as moving furniture. We have furniture there, so if you're physically capable of moving things around, that might be something that we would ask you to do at the ReStore. We have a specific need for people who can speak Spanish and interpret for us at the ReStore and also other areas of our organization. So if you're somebody who can speak both English and Spanish, we would love to talk to you. Give me a call at 610-373-3439, extension 301, and I'd love to talk to you and see where you might be able to fit in as a volunteer. We also have opportunities for Women Build, which is, it's actually a national effort to involve more women in Habitat for Humanity. We are doing things a little bit differently this year than we have in the past. In the past, it was just one day, the Saturday before Mother's Day. This year, we have expanded it to the week before Mother's Day. That gives us some other opportunities to give people a little bit more variety in dates and opportunities to choose. Right now, we still have opportunities available at the ReStore that week. Basically, all of the opportunities that I had talked about is something that is available for Women Build. Obviously, if you are not a woman and you want to volunteer that week, we're not going to turn you away. Give me a call and we'll see where we can fit you in.
Thanks, Penny. That was great. Seems like 2018 is the year of expansion for Habitat because one of our largest fundraisers, Birdhouse Challenge, is also being expanded this year as well. We want to represent all industries all over Berks County. So we are calling on to you. If you're a company, if you're a person with a hobby that loves to do woodworking or just create things, we're calling on to you to create birdhouses for us for Birdhouse Challenge. There is no fee to enter your birdhouse at Habitat. You can simply bring your birdhouse to the Doubletree by Hilton on the 1st of March between 3 and 5 p.m., and we will accept it. And later in the month, at the actual Birdhouse Challenge event, we will auction off the birdhouse. And all these funds raised by the event goes directly into our homes at top of Hawkins Street. Let me tell you a little bit about the event itself, Birdhouse Challenge, March 20th. It's being hosted at the Doubletree by Hilton in Reading. It's from 5:30 to 8:30 p.m. We are in need of sponsors. There are sponsorships ranging from $500 to $5,000. If you're a company or you are interested in being a sponsor for Habitat for Humanity's Birdhouse Challenge, please give me a call at 610-373-3439, extension 307, and I can give you more information about the event itself or the sponsorship levels as well. Tickets for the event are $75, and the ticket price includes admission, a 2-hour open bar, access to our live and silent auction, as well as music for the night. For tickets, please visit our website at www.habitatberks.org. Or again, you can give me a call at 610-373-3439, extension 307. Please visit our Habitat Facebook page as well, Habitat for Humanity of Berks County. Please visit our ReStore website, as well as our ReStore Facebook page, which is Berks ReStore, and there'll be more information about Birdhouse Challenge. And Joe also does daily, if not weekly, postings about what is available at the store. You can comment that you're interested. You can call in and reserve your items that are available at our ReStore. And for more information, please visit our website or give us a call again. And thank you for tuning in today. We had a great conversation. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm hoping our audience got a lot of information about our ReStore, about our volunteer needs, as well as our birdhouse challenge. Thank you for tuning in and see you next month.